clean what out?
This closet.
With the games?
Yeah, let's take everything out. We're not playing with it. We're just clearing it out.
Hey, this is Austin's day. We'll be really, really careful with it.
Yeah, put all the pieces for that game back to it.
This is just there's not a box. There's just that.
Okay, and stuff like that, Payne, you can get a Ziploc bag to put that stuff in. For her game. I want all the pieces of the back of some sort.
This is
okay. Oh, that's so nice.
I'll get a bag.
Now we're going to go ahead and start taking apart the shelving unit. Hey, Riker, be nice, bud. It's not time to play. Hey, you're not blowing up balloons right now. It's time to put that stuff away.
Yeah,
I'm going to put it here. I can't understand you. What is it, man?
It's the thing that comes off balloons. He won't put it back. It's supposed to go in here with the box.
Put it where it goes. This is pretty messy. Getting all those put away?
Yeah.
Thank you. These are my plans. I've got an existing shelf right there, but it's only 11 inches wide. I'm going to replace that with a board that's 15 inches wide. I'm going to have three more shelves there, vertical separator, and then I'm going to have 1 foot of coat closet instead of 3 feet of coat closet. Now, this shelf up here, as much as I wanted it, I'm probably not going to be able to do anything because the door, the top of the door is right here, and there'd be next to no way to get anything up there. So if I had one, it would have to be a really narrow shelf, maybe 8 inches wide. I'm not sure if I want to take the chance of putting anything up there or not, but we'll see. All right, this vertical support right here and this bracket need to come off. I've got this 23 1/4 all the way to the edge of that board. That board is 3/4 inch, so it's going to be right at 2 feet. That's only 20 inches right there, so I need it to come over to right there. So I'm just going to go ahead and take this off, take the bracket down, remove this, and we'll go from there. I do plan to reuse this closet bar, but I'm going to have to cut it so it'll fit within the smaller distance. See how this slides. But this is going to need to be 1 foot wide, so I'm going to have to cut both of these pieces, so it'll be, yeah, it'll be a lot smaller. But we usually, I don't think we've ever hung up a coat in here from guests, so even when we do have some guests in here, we should be fine to still be able to hang up 3 or 4 coats within that foot area. I also need to remove this. Shelf hanger. Maybe a little bit of damage there, but not bad. Now the next step is going to be to remove this. I'm still debating in my mind if I want a 15 inch shelf right here or leave that one that's slightly over 11. Alright, I'm going to take a razor knife and I'm going to go ahead and cut around the caulking right here, all around this piece, as this piece has to come off. I plan to leave these are already 15 inches wide and this whole one across the back there.
Okay.
You got that cut? I'm going to attempt to remove this without damaging it too bad. Steady, you're going up. Okay, I'll probably have to correct them here in just a little bit. There we go. Alright, just cut myself a little bit with the edge of that crowbar. I'm going to put a band-aid on after I clean it up. So I got a little bit of paint damage going on. I'm just going to go ahead and cut that off a little bit better. There we go. Got that piece out. Had some brads in there, maybe a 2-inch brad, maybe slightly longer. Yeah, I'm going to have to pull this off and fix that. Not a big deal. Yeah, let's see what the builder shoots on this. Yep, 2 inches. Now I've decided to go ahead and take that shelf off. It's only 11 inches wide, and I'm going to replace it with one that's 15 inches wide. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to attempt to cut along the caulking line to keep the paint from peeling off like it did. At least it wasn't too bad. Okay, there's a nice good cut. Hey, Riker, go get me a stool, please. I'm gonna wait for the stool to do that part. You can see here where I've cut along the caulk line all the way across. I'm trying to do that so that I won't pull the paint off like I did right here. I should have cut that a little bit deeper like I did on this side. All right, now I'm going to take a hammer and a board, and I start hitting this. Honey, you can't be right here. Go over there by the boys. As I expected. Looks like we've got the same 2-inch finishing nails. I just found from the top. See, I didn't cut it that good enough. I'm gonna have some more painting to do. So I'm gonna use this as a template to know how wide that is. I mean, I already know it's 36 inches, but this piece came from that exact spot where I'm putting another board. We'll get that cleaned up some. Once I put the new board on there and caulk it all up, it'll look a lot better. Who's there?
Baby.
Baby who? I just need you to make sure she doesn't get into the tools, bud. Now I'm gonna go outside and get my miter saw set up. You can tell we've got a little bit of snow. Can hear some snow blowers going off in the distance. Helped a neighbor unload his. They just moved in, weren't used to the snow yet. I'm going to go ahead and get this miter saw set up. That first shelf was actually 35 inches wide, not 36. So I'm going to get this set up and cut the first one. All right, I'm going to go ahead and test fit this board that I cut.
Yeah,
okay,
in your pockets. I could see your 35
inches. Oh, that's a nice tight fit. Doesn't come all the way down. Oh, I've got some stuff I need to knock off from the caulking from the front of that board, but it looks like it's going to fit in there just fine. Now something that I'm noticing, when I put this rod back in, it has a little lip that goes over this board. So I'm actually going to have to install that, possibly even cut a notch out on the bottom of the shelf when I go to put that back in here. So it's going to go from this side to right over to here. But if this is only 35 inches instead of a foot, that's going to be 11 inches. So that's how wide the coat rack is going to be. Like I said, not super wide, but I can definitely get two, maybe three or four coats in there and use the rest for games. I'm going to go ahead and take this shelf back out. Now, I've got so much space up there. These are 9-foot ceilings, but unfortunately, since these are only 7-foot doors, I can't do much up there. just got some caulking in here that's sticking up quite a bit. This is what it looks like in here, so you can see where I cut right there, and I cut down, got all that caulking off. It's all right that I peeled the paint off here, because this board's going to sip about 3/4 inch. It's not going to cover that, unfortunately, or that, but I'll have to repaint that. Sorry for moving so fast. And then the same thing over here, I cut all the caulking off. And this is pretty flat, so now I'm going to test fit this again and see how it does. Okay, I'm going to try this again. There we go. So if you can see, I mean, I will need to caulk that gap right there, but it does sit down flat. It comes all the way out to the edge of those boards. So here's the closet we're working on. Here's the closet next to it, linen closet. You can tell we've got lots of linens and things. We've got some shelves equally spaced out all the way down to the floor. And the idea is, as you can see, this top shelf right here is higher than this one. But I would like to cut the distance probably about the same height as those, so I'm going to measure those and see how high I need those, and then the bottom, we'll see how much is left over there. Okay, let's see. All right, so I've got 17 inches from the top of the top shelf to the top of the next shelf down, so minus 3/4 inch. I've got 16 1/4 inch gap between these shelves. All right, so I've got my plan here. I had this marked as 36 inches, but that's only 35. I do want my shelves to be 23 1/4 inches, plus the width of this vertical board, which is going to be made out of the same stuff. So that's going to be 24 inches even. So I need to measure from the wall 24 inches, and I'm going to do a straight line down, and I'm going to see how straight this wall is. If it's straight, if it's perfect, which we'll see, I'll be able to cut all three of these boards the same exact length. If it's not, if the wall dips in this way or bulges out, or does anything along those lines, then I'll have to cut those at different lengths and mark which one it is. But I'm going to go ahead and draw a vertical line right here at the 24-inch mark. Looks good. Now I know I'm going to have 16 1/4 spacing between each of these, so I'm just going to mark increments of 17 inches. Okay, and the next one will be 51, which I don't have, but I will go ahead and put a mark right there. So just a light little mark there, and let's see what we've got. Now, just for fun, I'm going to measure this again. Yep, we're at 24 inches. My next mark. Oh, nice. That's 23 15/16. This one is 23 15/16. 23 15/16. Possible I just measured this a little bit off. Okay, so yeah, the shelves are all going to need to be 23 15/16. I can dig that. And what I meant was 23 15/16 minus 3/4 inch for my vertical board. So I'm going to go do that math right now. All right, so I've got 23 15/16 instead of 24 inches. I'm going to subtract 3/4. I took it to the least common denominator here. So 16ths, took that to 16ths, so instead of 3/4. Multiply each one by 4, so we have 12/16. So 23 15/16 minus 12/16 equals 23 3/16. So these three boards, I need to cut to 23 3/16. Okay, now these supports, just like you see right here, this horizontal support, this one needs to be 24 inches, and these need to be the same width as this, 23 3/16. These, so those boards are 1/2 inch wide, and I don't want them to come all the way to the front. So I'm going to take a couple measurements. I'll go ahead and cut those as well. I do not want these to come out past that little bullnose round on the edge of those shelves. and so that I'll cut those just slightly shorter. I'm going to go ahead and do a dry fit again of this shelf with the supports that are already there. Those are 14 and a half inches long. I just took a measurement. There we go. All right, that actually looks great. That's right where I want them. So those need to be 14 and a half inches. So that's 15 and a quarter at the very front of the round. Now that's assuming that my wall back here is straight up and down and level. Looks pretty good. It might be off just a hair, but that's not going to matter. Go ahead and cut those. As you can see from the drawing right here, I need three supports, 1, 2, 3, that are 23 and 3/16, and then I need six that are 14 and a half inches, 2, 4, 6. I've already got this, and I've already got that. This side of the coat hanger, I'm just gonna screw right into the vertical particle board. All right, so I need to sand these things down as much as I don't want to. I need to get all this ready to paint again. I don't wanna do it after I get all my shelves in. Two reasons. For one, it's going to be harder to reach up in here. And second, I'm going to get all that dust on my new shelves. Then I have to clean them really, really well. Now, this paint that's coming off, yeah, I've got to do what I can with that. And I've got this caulking. I need to remove that as well. So I'm going to go ahead and get busy. All right, that looks good.
Addy, beep, beep.
What's the matter, Addy? Baby's what? Baby's broken? All right, it is your turn, bud. All right, I've got these shaved down a little bit. I'm going to have that go right back over. This side got it shaved down some. Need to sand that better. And that's this part's going to be covered up. Up here is not, so I did some sanding there. As well as down here. You can still see a little bit of a line, but that is pretty thin right there. I'm just going to be able to paint right over all of that. As you can see, I've made quite the mess on the floor and on the trim. I need to vacuum that up with the shop vac. I'm also quite dusty up here up top. I need to get all that cleaned up. I've got my big shop vac here.
Watch out, sweetie.
Five horsepower, 12 gallon. And I've got this attachment on. And I'm going to go ahead and clean this up.
Can you turn it on for me?
So there's actually no way I can just paint over this. I've got to get some mud on here, make it look a little bit better. If nothing else, fill up all those little holes that we had. I'm gonna put a little bit on that, as well as on this side. I'm gonna try the mask. I'm gonna pick mine as best I can. You alright, sweetheart? You hurt your foot? Are you okay? I'm thinking between all the sanding as well as this, you should not be able to see any of those paint lines where I had to scrape it up and sand it. Starting to knock it down. So I definitely got more than I needed. I'll sand that a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of this while I'm at it. All right, so you're gonna stand right here. Okay, now what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold
hold this side over here. So just stand over there all the way on that end. Okay, that looks good. We're going to flip it over this way. I need to take another move. Two more. 23 and 3/16. That's perfect. Okay, I'm going to put this one over here for now. Okay, now I need 6 that are 14 inches.
Wait, 6 that are 14 inches? I don't know.
Some more. Okay, hold it right there. Can you push it my way just a little? That's good.
Now the other closet in our master bedroom, the bottom of this has a cutout like this, and then it's suspended hanging off of the floor. I don't really want it to hit the floor because then I'd have to glue it to the tile or find some other way to keep it from wiggling back and forth, but this is going to be so close. The bottom shelf's going to be right here. This is going to be so close. Just imagine this were flipped upside down. This is going to be so close to that that it should not wiggle at all. This is a 45 degree angle. I marked it with this. This is a 4-inch long line that I'm going to cut right there.
Yes, that's the tile.
For tile?
Uh-huh. All right, let's test this. Ready? Yep, it's on. I need that push bar, bud.
Push bar. Push bar.
Yep. Here, you hold it and hand it to me in just a minute, okay?
Push bar.
A different way because it's not going through. All right. What I'm gonna have to do is set it up on this other side. Yes. All right. That should do it. Should be half an inch wide. Let's see how good we did. Yep, half an inch. Perfect. I'm always looking for a good excuse to use my angle grinder. Thank you.
This concludes video one. Please stay tuned for the rest of the series.
Alright, I'm going to go ahead and do my first one. I've got my compressor set to about 70 psi. My first mark right here is 17 inches. So the shell's going to sit on top of this 3/4 inch, and then I'll have 16 1/4 between there and there. I'm going to get this all leveled up. Looks good to me. What's going on? The first one. So same thing, I'm going to measure down 17 inches. And then from there, another 17 inches. Okay. Time to get these other three nailed in. There's a bit of a bevel on this. I'm having that on the front, on the lower part, in case anyone looks up in there at it. Level edge right here. I'm putting that problem down on the front side in case anyone happens to look at it. Thank you. do a dry fit with the shelves and the side piece and see how it goes. Now it's time to go ahead and nail them in.
I need to cut a little notch on the top of this, as well as up on the trim up there, support. That way this will sit down in there instead of lifting up the shelf up there. So I'm going to see what I can do with the razor knife. Don't need to do much. I'm sure I have a better tool for this, but I don't need to take that much off. So I'm just going to see if I can chip it off a little bit at a time. Okay, let's see how that sets in there. It's a little high on this side. Now that is good. Now I need to do the same thing up here on this trim support piece. This one is substantially easier to cut because it's MDF. It's that particle board.
think we're in business now. So I'm going to put some liquid nails on the top for up there, as well as on the sides of these shelves. Wipe off some of this excess glue while it's still wet.
All right, I've got it all nailed together. I do have a few breads I need to break off. I accidentally shot them through. I couldn't get close enough to the wall. So I've got a little bit of glue that splooged out. This back one, this is the first one I did. I wasn't close enough to the wall at all. I have lots of breads sticking through on that one. Overall, I'd say it's pretty dang good. Fairly straight up and down. You can see the detail I did here at the bottom. And this is where I wanted this floating. If it was going all the way down to the ground, it'd be very wobbly, and I didn't want to have to glue it to the floor or use some other means to secure it down there. Now I'm going to go ahead and put this in. See if I can do this with one hand. Just going to slide it in there and there. Now I need to screw that in. And as you can see, like I was saying, not going to fit a ton of coats, but we are going to hopefully get all of these games in there on the shelves. I almost forgot. I do have a few tree pieces that I need to put over here on this other side. This one's got a little nail sticking through it. Cut it as short as I can to make it. Be very careful with those when I go to cough that with my. None on that one. The bottom one. I do have one down there. That one. Now I'm going to go ahead and put the rest of these trim pieces in. Well, back to the drawing board. I'm going to look for more finishing nails. I'm going to go ahead and screw this coat rack back in. Run it all the way yet. I'm going to make sure I get both of these in first. All I could find in my hardware selection were these 1 and 1/4 inch nails. They're actually 1 and 1/8. So I'm going to drive those with a hammer, take a punch, punch in the heads. Now, in an attempt to hold this all together better, since I know my kids are probably going to climb on these shelves, I'm going to glue these in, and then I'm going to drive the finished nails through them. Did not come through the other side. I'm only going to probably drive three of these for support and let the glue actually do all the work. These are just to hold it up nice and tight up against there. Slight dent. Is it that's going to work. I believe that's going to help hold this board on. I'm gluing it all together. Move this out of the way. Don't want that to accidentally go off. I've still got a little bit of this left, this liquid nails. I'm going to wrap the end right here with some shipping tape so that I can go ahead and use that again in the future. I'm going to use a little bit of pre-mixed drywall mud on some of the little holes in here before we paint it.
Thank you.
So you may have noticed, but I've got the boards right here. I totally forgot to cut one for this bottom piece. In fact, I'm going to have to do it at a 45-degree angle as well, just like those other ones. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and cut that. Okay, so I've also cut this one at the same angle, 45-degree angle, so it'll match and fit up under there nicely. Punch. There it is. Mud those up real quick and I'll be right back. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and do some silicone, some caulking around here. Alex Fast Dry, this stuff works great. Just gonna do a thin bead and then just spread it, squeeze it out, and then I'm gonna take my finger and I'm gonna spread it across and make a perfect bead. which lasted more than my door project.
I've got my damp cloth. I'm going to go ahead and tack everything down, just wipe everything down real good.
Popcorn break. Ah.
I've got this damp wash rag. I'm going to go ahead and tack everything down. Preparation for paint. Sticker on here. Mark removal. I'm gonna need some more silicone on that bottom one there.
some of that still wet. It says you can paint it in 20 minutes, but I had to put some of that on real thick because I had a bigger crack. What's the matter, bud?
My head is polio.
By your eye?
No, my head is polio.
Let me move your finger. Let me see it. Oh, you're going to be all right. Looks like you might have a little bruise, but it's not bad. My wife painted it today while I was at work and did a great job. Matches the walls that were in there.